Evening and welcome to our time of evening prayer. Apologies for the slight delay. I got caught in the showers or in the rains outside and in changing suddenly realised I'd left my glasses in the house. It became clear when I looked at the list of intentions for tonight and realised it was all a blur. So we come to this evening prayer. We continue our novena of prayer, as it were, for the deacons elect, for Sean and for Ian, praying not just for them, but for ourselves, that through their ministry we will be enriched and strengthened as a parish community. Their ministry of word and of the ministry at the altar and of service in the community highlights for us that which are those key elements in our lives too. We recognise that they enrich and strengthen us. We come, therefore, to God, praying that we may have that strength too for those we love and for those for whom this evening we offer our prayers. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. O God, come to our aid. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Alleluia. Praise my soul, the King of heaven. To his feet your tribute bring. Ransomed, healed, restored, forgiven. Who like me his praise should sing? Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise the everlasting King. Praise him for his grace and favour to our fathers in distress. Praise him still, the same forever, slow to chide and swift to bless. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, glorious in his faithfulness. Father-like he tends and spares us, well our feeble frame he knows. In his hands he gently bears us, rescues us from all our foes. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, widely as his mercy flows. Angels help us to adore him, ye behold him face to face. Sun and moon bow down before him, dwellers all in time and space. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise with us the God of grace. You cannot serve both God and wealth. Hear this, all you peoples, give heed all who dwell in the world, men both low and high, rich and poor alike. My lips will speak words of wisdom, my heart is full of insight. I will turn my mind to a parable, with the harp I will solve my problem. Why should I fear in evil days the malice of the foes who surround me, men who trust in their wealth and boast of the vastness of their riches? For no man can buy his own ransom or pay a price to God for his life. The ransom of his soul is beyond him. He cannot buy life without end, nor avoid coming to the grave. He knows that wise men and fools must both perish and leave their wealth to others. Their graves are their homes forever, their dwelling place from age to age, though their names spread wide through the land. In his riches, man lacks wisdom. He is like the beasts that are destroyed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. You cannot serve both God and wealth. Build up treasure for yourselves in heaven, says the Lord. This is the lot of those who trust in themselves, who have others at their beck and call. Like sheep, they are driven to the grave, where death shall be their shepherd, and the just shall become their rulers. With the morning, their outward show vanishes, and the grave becomes their home. But God will ransom me from death and take my soul to himself. Then do not fear when a man grows rich, when the glory of his house increases. He takes nothing with him when he dies. His glory does not follow him below. Though he flattered himself while he lived, men will praise me for all my success. Yet he will go to join his fathers, who will never see the light anymore. In his riches, man lacks wisdom. He is like the beasts that are destroyed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Build up treasure for yourselves in heaven, says the Lord. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive glory and honor. Worthy are you, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power. For you created all things, and by your will they existed and were created. Worthy are you, O Lord, to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed men for God from every tribe and tongue and people and nation. You have made us a kingdom and priests to our God, and we shall reign on earth. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honor and glory and blessing. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive glory and honor. All have sinned and forfeited God's glory, and all are justified through the free gift of his grace by being redeemed in Christ Jesus, who was appointed by God to sacrifice his life so as to win reconciliation through faith. You will give me the fullness of joy in your presence, O Lord. I will find happiness at your right hand forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Do great things for us, O Lord, for you are mighty, and holy is your name. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me. Holy his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones and raises the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his sons forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Do great things for us, O Lord, for you are mighty, and holy is your name. Christ is the shepherd of his flock. He loves and cares for his people. We turn to him and trust and say, Lord, we need your care. Christ our Lord, you are pastor of all the ages. Protect our Bishop Richard and all the pastors of your church. Be with those who are persecuted for their faith and those cut off from the support of the church. Good Shepherd, in their pain and isolation, may they know your care. Bring healing to the sick. Give nourishment to the hungry. We remember those who make our laws and those who apply them. Lord, give them wisdom and discernment. Gather the flock for which you laid down your life. Bring home to their father's house all who have died in your peace. We pray for Sean Evans, and for Ian Hunt, as they prepare for ordination. Jen asks that we might pray for her friend Mary, who's having difficulty speaking and swallowing. Rachel asks that we might pray for Ursula, who's had a stroke alongside her cancer and lost the use of her left side. They're both very much in need of our prayerful support. Mary asks that we might pray for Eileen going into hospital tomorrow for a hip replacement. Anne asks that we might pray for her son who has COVID and for his wife and daughter at this difficult time. Elizabeth asks we might pray for strength and comfort for Nick Biliak and for his family. Ingrid asks that we might pray for Jean Meller. We continue pray for Pope Francis as he recovers from his operation. We pray too for Monsignor Canon Thomas John Nalen, who the Holy Father named today as an auxiliary bishop in Liverpool. Susan writes asking prayers for her husband David. Prayers in thanksgiving, I should say. She kindly too says some nice things about myself and Father Roy and asks that we might be prayed for. Again in thanksgiving. And asks too that we might pray for Father Thomas and his return to good health. And so we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Yours is the day, and yours is the night, Lord God. Let the sun of justice shine so steadily in our hearts that we may come at length to that light where you dwell eternally. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Pray that you'll have a blessed evening. And we pray too that we may be inspired by that example of Mary. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, Espes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exsule filii Evae, a te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea rego, advocata nostra, illos tuos, misericordes loquelos, et nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fruntum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O dulcis Virgo Maria. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.